It's a great time to be a car enthusiast, a particularly great time to be an enthusiast of cool off-roaders. We already have the all-new Thar, the Jimny, that's coming. We have the G in both AMG as well as 350 diesel form. We have the Wrangler also in the Rubicon edition, and now we have the all-new Land Rover Defender. Off-roaders, SUVs, icons, call it what you may, but stuff like the Defender, they trade on emotion. And the emotional aspect starts with the way it looks. This new Defender, it looks really, really good. So appealing, but it is not retro. It is not a copy of the old Defender. It is not classic in its shape. It is thoroughly modern, but drawing just the right amount of inspiration from Land Rover's back catalog. If you thought the exterior of the Defender was cool, the interiors are equally cool. The styling is functional yet funky. Now, I like the interesting materials. So there is wood on the center console, also on the door handles. And this does feel like wood, the texture. There are exposed screw heads, which is a look back at the history of the Defender. The Defender was a utilitarian tool. The materials used, I quite like it. They're these soft touch plastics, though this plastic on the steering wheel, it could have been better finished. But again, this is supposed to be functional, right? Even though it is expensive and even though it is a luxury SUV, it is supposed to hark back to the original Defender. And speaking about technology, the infotainment, it is JLR's brand new and most sophisticated infotainment system. Now, normally we don't spend too much time talking about the infotainment, but I must run you through all the menus because there really is a lot. I've actually spent an hour playing around with it to try and understand everything on it. So we'll quickly run you through all of the functions that are there on the infotainment. So now this is weight sensing, where the car understands what you're going through and it shows you how many meters of water you can go through. This is on the lowest setting. Now, if I increase the height, the water wading depth increases to a maximum of 900 millimeters, and that is quite a lot. You folks out in Mumbai will love it for the monsoons. You got this 4x4 info, so all of it on one screen. This shows the bearing, your tilt angle, lean angle, what is happening with the differentials, the steering wheel, the angle that it is pointing at. Let's go back. So that's your wheel info, which we've gone through. Then you have your driving style. So it shows you all your energy consumption, how many hours you've been driving. It's like your trip computer. Swipe, your impact on the energy. So your eco tips, slope assist, the compass, the navigation. You can connect your phone via Apple CarPlay, Android Auto. You can select your media. There's more out here. So this gives you all the off-road information, your weight sensing, low traction launch. So that is if you have snow, it'll let you launch in snow. This is not for 0 to 100 times, but this is to get moving on very slippery surfaces. It shows you your vehicle dimensions. So 5.01 meters in length, the weight height, and also your off-road angle. So your approach, departure, breakover, ramp angle, all of that it shows you. You can change it to meters or feet. We are Indian, so we'll stick with meters. More stuff. There's a lot more stuff, honestly. So vehicle dimensions, eco data, climate, the cameras, cool stuff. So this is like a 360 degree camera, and it's just so cool because it shows you everything out here and the stuff that is nearby. So including the cars that are parked around you. So this is really cool. Plus, you also have the forward camera, which actually looks through the bonnet. So when you're off-roading, you have a view of the road ahead, which this basically eliminates your bonnet. So this is your view if you were sitting on the grill of the car. And then of course your rear, okay, the crew sitting back there. So those are the camera angles. And then I must run you through all the menus on the terrain response. Now this has both terrain response 2 as well as configurable terrain response. It is activated via this button out here. So this button, I honestly don't like the way you activate it. I would like a nice chunky button out there, But this is the button that you use to activate your terrain response to, and then you use this rotary dial. So you have eco, comfort, grass, gravel, snow, mud ruts, sand, rock crawl, wading. There's a wade program, and then you can configure this. So in the configure program, you can adjust a whole load of parameters. So your differentials, if you want it automatically to engage, if you want to just engage the limited slip at the center or the center and the rear. You can have the powertrain in different modes, the steering in different modes, the traction control in different modes. So less wheel spin off-road or more wheel spin, or you can reset that. So that's the configurable terrain response. That is like how on a M car, for instance, you have the M1 and M2 buttons, which you can set it to your mood. Configurable terrain response is that you can adjust the height of the suspension. These are the buttons out here to adjust the height of the suspension. You have low ratio. All Defenders get low ratio. You can switch off traction control. This is for your hill descent control. In terms of the equipment for off-roading, it has a lot of it. Serious amount of equipment on this car. The Defender also has an unbelievable number of USB slots. So there's a normal USB, there's a USB-C, there is a fast charging USB out here on the front, and you can leave your phone on the tray there. It's not going to slip. There are two power sockets and two USBs at the back. There's a USB behind both the seats. There is also a power socket out here if you throw away the cigarette lighter. You can really run your office from here. This is the Defender 110. That is the long wheelbase Defender, and it has got plenty of space. The driver's seat adjusted to my driving position, and just look at the amount of free knee room. There's a lot of headroom, comfortable seats, enough width for three. Or you have this nice big center armrest. This is very comfortable. And there are two extra seats at the back for the kids. Under the skin, the Defender is no longer a body on frame. In fact, this is closely related to the Discovery and the Range Rover. It has a variation of the D7 all aluminium monocoque, and it has got independent suspension with air springs. The benefits of monocoque construction, it is really, really comfortable. In the Defender, you can actually cruise and do long distances with ease. The handling is not bad at all, and in fact, this feels like a modern SUV. This has been inspired by the past, but unlike those other SUVs, which we'll come to later, which have been inspired by their icons, their military-derived ancestors, this does not have military underpinnings. The Defender, it stays true to Land Rover's heritage in that it gets all the off-road bits and bobs, yet it is also modern, it's comfortable, it's luxurious, it does everything that you would want from a modern expensive SUV. The Defender, it really is comfortable. It deals with these off-road tracks with no effort at all. Just takes it all in its stride. Now, it has all the off-road modes and all the off-road equipment that you would want, especially in something carrying the Defender badge. But on the road also, it feels very comfortable, extremely modern, extremely luxurious also. This is a Defender that you could be driven to work in every day, and you can drive to your off-road trails when the mood, the fancy strikes you. Good thing it's got a blind spot warning to warn you of stuff around there, but it's a bit too large for our traffic conditions. Also, these wing mirrors, they do create a lot of wind roar above at say triple digit speeds on the highway. So you can hear that, and these tires, which have a slightly aggressive off-road pattern, a surprisingly aggressive off-road pattern, which looks cool, but that also creates tire roar. Does it make it tiresome to drive on the highway? Not at all, because this is really comfortable. Easily it cruises at high triple digit speeds and comfortably chews miles. This is a 2-liter petrol engine with the automatic gearbox. The diesel, you can order it now. It's not yet on sale, but you can order it. And somehow I think that a diesel would suit the character of the Defender much better than this petrol. Not that the petrol is lacking, it's got enough power for our highways, enough of torque. The gearbox, it is not the sharpest or quickest gearbox, but it's a gearbox that tells you that, hey buddy, what's the rush? Where's the fire? This is a Defender, take it easy. Eventually you will get to the ends of the earth, and then you can stick it in to low ratio and go further. The charm of the Defender lies not in its off-road ability. After all, who are we kidding? How many people are actually going to take a Defender off-road? The charm lies in the promise behind that badge. The promise of go-anywhere ability, of indestructibility, of the ability to cross continents and win wars. The ability to go to the ends of the earth, find sunsets, maybe film another episode of God Must Have Gone Crazy. And those are precisely the reasons why we love something like the G-Wagon. What goes up against the Defender is the G350 diesel, but fact is, there are more AMG G-Wagons in India than there are diesels. And that is what we have here from a friend of Evo India. The G-Wagon is among the most iconic cars on the planet, the design staying true to the original launched 40 years ago, while it continues to run on a body-on-frame chassis like the original, which was designed for military purposes. The interiors were also thoroughly updated, and it remains a very, very high-quality cabin with high-resolution screens, beautiful touches, and looking absolutely gorgeous when the sun goes down. It retains the three locking differentials that takes pride of place on the center console via the three big bold switches. The G was thoroughly updated 2 years ago, and thanks to the S-Class derived front suspension, it rides much better while also handling much nicer. Performance from the 4-liter AMG V8 is ridiculous. The best part though is the thunder that the exhaust makes. The more sensible G350 diesel makes 281 bhp and 600 Nm of torque, which is quite enough in a ladder frame 4x4. On a purely emotional level, the G is still the big daddy. It is not a sensible buy, but if tests like these were judged purely on emotion, it would be the clear winner. So let's quickly move on to a more sensible comparison. While the G to the Defender comparison is a bit too far-fetched, what are close rivals are these two, the Jeep Wrangler and the Land Rover Defender. Both have history, both have heritage, both have mad capability, and both look f***ing cool. Today's Jeeps are built much in the same way that Jeeps have always been built, a body bolted onto a frame. But much has changed over the past 7 decades. So there is extensive bushing between the body and the frame to reduce noise, vibration and harshness. And the axles are suspended by coil springs, not leaf springs. Hardcore off-roaders insist that the Jeep's live axles give it better capability off the road. It allows the tires to remain in contact with the ground for much longer and thus gives you more traction. Now, unlike the Defender, but like the G-Wagon, the Wrangler also gets locking differential, so you can lock the front and rear differential or the rear only via this nice fancy button out here. You can disconnect the sway bar, which is the anti-roll bar. In terms of capability, the Wrangler Rubicon is mighty. Absolutely mighty. If I had to bet my life on an off-roader to take me to the ends of the earth, it would be this, because I have driven it. I have experienced what it is capable of. Where we are driving right now, this is nothing. This is child's play. I won't even call this off-road. For this, the Wrangler will not even wake up in the morning to deal with these things. This is like a highway for it. But when it comes to serious trails, the Wrangler Rubicon comes into its element. This is an immensely capable beast. Now, we are not testing off-road ability, but if we were, the Wrangler's 44 degree approach angle betters the Defender's 38 degree approach angle. But in all other respects, the Defender is actually better. It has more ground clearance with the air suspension raised to its max setting, and it has better water wading ability. So all of you in Mumbai would actually really like the Defender's water wading ability. Now, while live axles are brilliant off-road, they're not so great on the road. That said, it's not like the Wrangler is unlivable or anything like that, but it is not as smooth as a monocoque, which is what the Defender is. This is bouncy. When you hit a bump, the rear, it hops. So you have to be careful. And the brake pedal feel, that's the big difference. This long travel and soft brake pedal has been designed for great precision when you're driving off-road. But on the road, you want more feel, more feedback, and a sharper bite, which the Wrangler doesn't offer. No problems in terms of braking distances, but it is just feel. Another compromising factor for the Wrangler Rubicon's on-road ability are these tires. Now, these are proper off-road tires. So on-road, they are a bit noisy and they don't give you great handling. And in fact, as far as the Wrangler is concerned, it's best not to talk about handling. Off-road handling is fine. It's fun. And in fact, with rear-wheel drive, you can slide it around also a bit. What do I think of the Wrangler Rubicon? I think it is immensely cool. Okay, it is a bit compromised because of the live axles, but it is coil sprung, so it's not unlivable. It is immensely cool. It's the only one of these lifestyle SUVs where you can take off the roof. If you want, you can also take off the doors. This lets you breathe in the outdoors. It lets you live the outdoor lifestyle. With the Wrangler, it's not like your heart is in your mouth when you take this expensive SUV off the road. In fact, when you're driving the Wrangler, it indulges you. It urges you to hit the off-road trails and discover places that you never knew existed, like where we are. Though a lot of people seem to have found it and a lot of construction is happening out here. But anyway, the Wrangler lets you explore the wild outdoors in luxury, in comfort, and all while looking so, so cool. This is the face of an SUV to all of us. This is what SUVs are all about. There's no way you cannot love the Wrangler. Is the Wrangler relevant? It definitely is still relevant in this space. And at 65 lakh rupees, it's actually a fair bit cheaper than the Defender. Far from making the Wrangler irrelevant, the Thar has actually made the Wrangler even more relevant. More people are flocking to Jeep dealerships, and these are dealers who've told me that the Wranglers are now selling more because people want something unique, different from the Thar. And while retaining that intense, immense off-road ability. I think the Defender is the coolest SUV in Land Rover's lineup right now. It starts with the way it looks. It looks just so phenomenal, so desirable. Then there is the ability, the comfort, the monocoque chassis. It gives it such great cruising ability. It is comfortable, yet it handles well. It has off-road ability, yet it can do your daily commute. You can actually be driven around in a Defender. Just imagine that, driven around in a Defender. Now, would I have liked the Defender to be an old school body on ladder frame? Maybe not. Okay, there is that lunatic fringe like myself who would have preferred that feel of the body frames, but honestly, that is just too hardcore. Being a monocoque, it will appeal to a far wider audience. This will find appeal across the board, from hardcore off-roaders to just general enthusiasts. Also, it has so many variants, the 90, the 110, the 3-door, the 5-door. Eventually, this will be made in India. It will get the diesel engine. It will get more affordable. You will see more Defenders on the road, and our roads will be a much nicer place. Our off-road trails will be much cooler with Defenders running on them. Catch the full story of the Land Rover Defender versus the G-Wagon and Jeep Wrangler in the November issue of Evo India, which is on newsstands now. You can order it online at evoindia.com/magazine and also online on Amazon. Subscribe to the Evo India channel and hit the bell icon to keep pace with the thrill of driving.